morning. I'm going to talk about architecture and fabrication, how a house could be built and how we could improve with the current technology the quality of our living spaces, the affordability, and share this with greater markets and people. We think that this is the present and the future of architecture, and this house that we built in Madrid is our manifesto, our starting point. We prefabricated all this house using civil engineering parts, perfectly assembled and balanced, to demonstrate how prefabrication could be the way to create amazing, inspiring, and affordable spaces to live. This house was based in these engineering parts, balanced in consonance and in harmony, in equilibrium with this rock of granite of 20 tons that put all the parts together. This is our house in Madrid, the Meroscopian house, that is full of air and full of life to inhabit the structure that, as you can see, differs very little the house and the structure that created it. This house is a space to share with our family. It's a space to share in transparency, in communion with outdoors, in very intimate relationship with nature. This is the space that we were living in Spain and the space that we would like to have here in Boston when we came, the full family. This house is built in Madrid, and when we came to Boston, we were looking for a same space, a similar space to live. We started struggling with Zillow in the search of housings around MIT, where our Pop Lab is founded, and we wanted to be closer with good schools like this one. And we discovered how insane the prices are, how expensive these houses become, and also how these houses were responding to an old American dream, a lifestyle, a technology, and a formal and spatial aspect that was not the way we understood house should be. And also, when you come as an immigrant to the United States, you don't have financial history. And this was part of the problem that we have to solve. So we actually went low to high in the Zillow browser, and we found the cheapest place in the area. I think it was the cheapest place in Massachusetts, and this was our dream house. A three-bay garage, very unfinished yet, but with a lot of potential. So we thought that we could build the house of our dreams. I recruited a group of young architects and tell them, let's build the technology that could be available and fit the house in Brookline. It was the same beam, but ultralight, that could be lifted and transported easily, and that could be strongly insulated to the weather in Boston. So we got hands-on, and without being skilled to build a house, we crafted the fabrication, putting together the technologies from the North American tradition of building houses with our European ones. Framing, but in steel instead of in wood. Creating thick walls, but very light, filled with foams, and insulating materials that could be cladded with cement boards. It's a different material palette, but what we created was a very affordable, lightweight technology that could be packed in a container, because we were going to make the move to the United States, but not only moving our stuff, our furnishing, our memories, we were going to move the full house. So we packed it in containers, and we made the trip to the United States. The house in one side, our family in the other one. When we arrived to Brookline, two blocks away from this place, it was like receiving an Amazon pack instead of How good it was the full house that we had to unpack, crane and assembly together, the same way we did in Madrid, but with these pieces that came with the kitchen, the bathroom, the closets, the furnishing. Everything was embedded into these walls. These walls had to be assembled with total precision as a Swiss watch, and it took 7 days of craning and putting all these parts together in perfect balance. We think that this is the way architecture should move on, to make it really affordable, real, technological, and overall exciting. We think that architecture has to inspire and create poetic spaces that make our lives better. The house was constructed above the garage, but the garage is still there. It's coated with a thin layer of vegetation that hopefully will grow next spring, but it was recycled, it wasn't turned down. We just created a big room above where all our family could again enjoy all their activities without separating ourselves into rooms. A big room where we could have our meals, play, study, do some work, and where we could enjoy also the light and the vistas from the neighbor's trees, and where at night even all that activity after dinner could be transformed into a fantastic bedroom. The bed comes from the wall, and we still enjoy that big space that we created above. Good night.